reading an article in the paper the other day. Fella jumped off some mountain with one of them kites, Batman kites, and it didn't work, and he slammed into something and killed him. And it said, diver dies because of freak accident. That ain't a freak accident. You jumped off a building with a kite on your back. That's a dumbass accident is what that is. A freak accident. I'll tell you what a freak accident is. You're down there at the local, you know, Stop and Shop down there and getting gas, and unbeknownst to you, there's two clowns in a knife fight. And one of them falls and stabs you in the face. That's a freak accident right there, all right? Read another article one time. This is why I don't like polls. I seen an article, they said they polled in Washington, D.C. They polled 2,500 women. Said, now that Bill Clinton's way older, would you sleep with Bill Clinton? Unbelievable. 94% said not again. Thank you. Good night. Thank you so much. Good night. Thank you. All right. I'll stay. All right. You convinced me. I'm going to hang out for a while. Remain seated. Stupid polls. Well, the polls indicate I ain't never been polled. You ever been polled? I've been polled. There's only one poll I ever trusted. That's the polls I do at my shows. And I done one last night, and I believe this. I polled all my audience last night. 87% of them said at this point in time during my show, they want their money back. I've been, you used one of the 13%. 13%. Yeah, 13% right there. Yeah, right? I know my dadgum math. You know, I work a lot of fairs. I love working fairs. It's awesome because I grew up in fairs, and I love fairs. What has happened to the clientele at the fairs lately, though? Holy smokes, I was up there the other day. There's a dude walking like he's bleeding from the nose, you know, walking like he got a daggum fart stuck sideways heading down that thing down there. Looked like a Greyhound bus overturned. He came walking in trying to get help or something. I mean, it's unbelievable at these fairs. By the way, anybody ever ride a Greyhound bus? I used to ride them back in the early days of comedy. Holy smokes, only thing slower than a Greyhound bus is the people on the daggum bus. They're a good value, though. I went from Sanford, Florida, all the way to Lincoln, Nebraska one time. $49. Oh, man. 119 days. Oh, smokes. And the big selling point at the time was now with more leg room, what they needed was more headroom so I could have hung myself halfway through the trip. A couple years ago, my grandma playing bingo at the fair. Won her a spa package. But I'll be honest, I think they gave her the wrong package. She said that she was able to tolerate the Botox, but during the Brazilian wax, she farted and blinded the attendant. Lord, I apologize for that right there, and be with the starving pygmies down in New Guinea. Amen. Bless you. I saw my grandma topless 2 weeks ago. Oh, that's the last time I let her drink before a concert. I'll tell you that much. It was embarrassing. It was windy out, so her boobies was flying around like one of them inflatable wind dancers in front of an oil change shop, you know what I mean? It is horrible. The Oak Ridge boys didn't even want to do an encore after they saw that. They Thanks a lot, Grandma. Your flapping titties just cost me an encore of giddy up, boom, pop a mow mow right there. All right. I kid my grandma. My grandma's awesome. She's actually a widower. She's trying to meet some fellas now. She's on one of them elderly dating services. She went on the internet now. Metamucil Mingle. She's been on that now for a while. I think she's on medical marijuana. I ain't sure, but she gave us a quilt the other day made out of Taco Bell wrappers, so there's something going on there. We almost lost my granddad. He's 93 years old. He almost passed away on us. He almost lost him on the toilet. He almost died on the toilet. Boy, what a way to go right there. Whew. Can you imagine dying on the toilet? I mean, what do you say to the relatives at the wake to make them feel better? I mean, that's a tough one there. Yeah. Mrs. Egerhoff, We're real sorry to hear about Ed, man. That's, but at least he died doing what he loved, you know. That's the thing that we heard he fought till the bitter end, and that's the thing. He wasn't a quitter, so he got it out, and we're excited, and that's nice. And we're going to light a match tonight and remember him at midnight, and hopefully... I read a story one time, a fella got bit by a snake sitting on the toilet. He got interviewed and said, first thing I thought was I need to call animal control. That's the first thing he thought? If I got bit by something similar, first thing I'd think is, what the hell did I eat last night? Dadgum, my food's circling back on me here. But we almost lost my grandpa. He sat on one of them power flush toilets. You ever see them energy savers? You flush it, just go like that. I mean, if you sit on it flush, it'll put a hickey on your hind end, I guarantee it. It will. But he sat on there, flushed it, boom, left nut down the drain. I ain't kidding you. True story. I wish it wasn't, but that's a true story. I'm trying to help him out. I'm trying to yank him off that thing right here. It's stuck in that little tube hole in there. It's like daggone Stretch Armstrong. Like, and finally, it come loose, slow motion, right at my daggone head. It hits me, boom, 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 boom. It was like them little knocker balls. You ever see them little knocker balls? There? Boom, 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 boom. Bloodied my daggone nose. My wife's like, what's going on in here? His twig and berries went MMA on me is what happened in here. I have had it.